So I went to college more than 20 years ago. Right. And there have been a lot of changes in our world since that time, but our colleges look pretty much the same. The changes have been a little bit on the outside. We have some fancy new buildings. We have some new majors. But it doesn't meet the world that we live in today. And this is a problem because we're not doing our best for people in this room. So the bad news is none of us in this room can change that system, certainly not by the time we're entering it. The fantastic news is all of us can change how we think about this system in order to make it work better for us. So today what I'm going to share with you are three specific ways that if you look at them sideways, shift a little bit about your thinking, you can make this system work better for you, make you more likely to learn stuff, make you more likely to be successful in college and after. So I quickly want to acknowledge that this talk is not about money. This is not about the price of college that's going up, is going up, will continue to go up. I think each of your situations here have their own particular circumstances that my generalizing about it probably won't serve you very well. I also don't think it's responsible for me or anybody else to try and persuade you and your families to think differently about money in just 10 minutes. So I just want to acknowledge it's an important issue, but it's not one we're talking about today. You know, people will talk about also about college as being a journey or being on an island, and there's mountains, and you might go through dangerous passes to get there. And this talk isn't really too much about the metaphor of stories about college, because college can be all those things or none of those things, depending on the time. But I just want to show you this picture of this island, because we will get back to it. Instead, what I wanted to focus on are three questions that I think probably many of you in this room and others your age might be struggling with. First is about where. Where's the best place? Where's the best place for you? About getting in and everything it takes about getting in. And then what kind of job will you have afterwards on the way out? And I don't think those questions serve me and my generation particularly well. And I certainly don't think they serve you very well. So I want to challenge you to throw them out, shift the way you think about it, and hopefully reduce a little bit of stress in your life. So first I want to attack where. Where should you go? Where's the best place? How far away do you want to get from your family? Where is an important question, but it pales in comparison to who. Who will you meet, and who will meet you? Who is greater than where? So here's a not secret about college that a lot of people won't tell you, is that everyone in college struggles, especially their first year. Now, like me, it might be your first DRF. You might have a personal problem, it might be a financial problem, a physical problem. Everybody struggles in college. It's the who that builds your resiliency and makes you more likely to get through that first hurdle and be successful later. Who is greater than where? There's a significant amount of research that backs up something that sounds obvious, might not be at the top of your mind. And that is students that build meaningful relationships with peers, with faculty, with staff, or with your boss. Those students are more likely to be engaged, they're more likely to learn more, and they're more likely to have meaningful employment after college, no matter where they go. Who is greater than where? So the second question I raise is about getting in. And I don't want to even imagine the combined amount of stress that's in a room full of high school students about getting into college and admissions and costs and time and energy. But I want to ask you, how often have you thought about getting out? And even if your plan is to attend community college for a couple years and then transfer, I suspect you're not phrasing the question very often in terms of getting out. I want you to understand that getting out is greater than getting in. And so what do I mean by that? You might not know that across the country, the six-year graduation rate at a degree-granting institution for first-time, full-time students is 59%. So that means if everybody in this room went to college, 4 out of 10 of you would not finish what you started. A handful of you would transfer, but most of you, your careers would be derailed for all any kinds of other reasons. And the reason this is important to understand is that the worst case scenario is to start college, you take on the debt of student loans, but you don't get the degree on the other side where the benefit comes later. So you would have all the costs of higher ed and none of the benefits. And incidentally, this is why you're better off majoring in college in something you love rather than something that people are pushing you towards because they have a thought about a particular career field. So a person who is successful even in a degree like art history, if they complete college, they will have more career choices, earn more money, overall be happier through their course of their life, even than somebody who takes some classes but not a great degree in a field like computer science or engineering or accounting or other things people are pushing you towards. Getting out is greater than getting in. So the third one is about jobs. Jobs, jobs, jobs. And it's understandable that people are afraid about jobs. And we think about how our world is changing. We think about globalization. And we think about what we're going to do to justify the investment we just made to get to college. But as much as we think about jobs, that pales in comparison to thinking about skills. Skills are greater than jobs. And so what that means is that the average American, by the time they turn 25, will have had 6.3 jobs. And across all those jobs, it's not the content that you take from a particular major, it's a combination of skills that you get in your coursework and your previous career. Skills are what are transferable across all of your jobs. Skills are greater than jobs also means to think about what you're learning, not just the content of something like art history, but how you get to do something, like look for patterns in historical documents that people haven't seen, making a persuasive case about something contemporary versus something in the past. Those are skills. You know, if we were in a room full of high school students, even just 10 years ago, and tried to tell you that one of the fastest growing jobs in 2014 would be mobile app developer, a room full of students wouldn't know what that is, what that even means. But if you had said, we need someone who knows how to learn new skills, learns how to communicate those skills, and then learn how to distinguish your work in a crowded marketplace, something like mobile app developer starts making more sense and sounds like something that could be. Anybody that tries to persuade the people in this room that they know what the job market is going to look like in 2020 is just guessing. They're just guessing. You're best served by focusing on your skills that you could apply to a wide variety of jobs, no matter what that market looks like. So skills are greater than jobs. So even if you believe me, if you're come with me on this, and you'd say that who is more important than where, that getting out is greater than getting in, and that skills are greater than jobs, you might say, so what? So what does that mean for you? And what that means is you're not as powerless as you might all feel. You're not as powerless about the situation you find yourselves in. And then if you shift your way of thinking on some pretty basic questions, you might find a way to get more value for yourself, both in the immediate present and the long-term future. So if we go back to the island and we think about that, yes, you'll be on this journey to go through college, and yes, there'll be a path that you might go, and there'll be barriers in front of you, and they might be mountains, they might be the river, there might be gates, there might be other people to help you along the way. But what I really want to challenge you to think about is when you're in a situation like college or any other chapter in your life, if you look at it sideways, you might see a pattern or something you'd never seen before. And so when you think about going to college, you're not fixed in what's presented to you. Thank you.